Perhaps with regards to duplicates, you actually don't want to keep or delete them. You just actually want to know which of these line items have duplicates. So what you can do, same thing, get it into a table form, get it into Power Query. So we've now got it. So you'll see we've got options to keep and remove. But in this case, we actually don't want to do that. We want to know how many duplicates are there. So either here in Home, there's a button called Group By, or under Transform, you've got that same button, Group By. And what we're going to do is, again, we'll just highlight them all. And when we click the Group By button, it goes, and because I've highlighted them all, it's saying, okay, we're going to specify the columns to group by. So it's going to group by where they're the same salesperson, date, product A, product B, product C. If you want to change that, you can delete it, move it up or down. You can add a grouping, you can remove a grouping, either by highlighting the columns or here. You then need to specify what must it do. So it's going to have that, that's great. Give it a new name, so for now I'm going to say count, and I just want something that'll count how many rows have that exact same grouping. If that's fine, let's see what it looks like. I'm going to say OK, and you'll see what it's done is it's added a new column, and all it tells us is how many times it sees that. So it groups this, and it tells you there were 11 of them. As you scroll down, you'll see that seems to be the only duplicates. Or you could filter here and see that there's those two options. So by using this technique, you can now create a report to know that, okay, that has been repeated 11 times. Let's go look at what other options you have there. So again, you could delete it and redo it. Or remember, you've got the little settings icon here, which will take us straight back into this. So let's leave the grouping, but you can obviously change that to suit you. We've got a new column name. What do you want to happen? And you'll see we have a whole bunch of options. Perhaps we want to sum something. So counting rows is fairly obvious. It just counts the number of rows. But I can say, well, actually, I want you to sum. And what must it sum? Salesperson code is clearly not going to do work. But let's say we want to sum product A sales. So if I go and I say OK now, notice it changes. So anywhere where there wasn't a duplicate just has the same number. But where there was a duplicate, it then shows how much that adds up to. Just going back in here, you'll see you can do an average, a median, min, max, count rows, count the distinct rows, or you can do all rows. So let's see what happens with all rows. When I say OK, what it does, puts it in, you'll see there's something, the name is not relevant anymore, but we've got it here. But notice you've got the expand option. So it's grouped by, so we're only seeing that item once. But when we then say expand it, it then just wants to know what you want to include. So I think we're going to keep all the original stuff. And when I say OK, what you'll see is it has created exact duplicates. So now it's actually showing all the items again. So in this case, it's a bit repetitive, but it allows you to actually see everything that appears in these areas.